द ओवरऑल लॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ योर डेटाबेस. सो द डेफिनेशन बेसिकली ईआर डायग्राम इज नथिंग बट इट विल कंसिडर ऑल द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ योर सिस्टम और योर एंटरप्राइज एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट इट विल गिव यू कंप्लीट एंटरप्राइज स्कीमा इन वन व्यू. That is nothing but represent complete structure of your database known as a ER diagram. Okay, so basically it is very useful in mapping the meanings and interaction between the different entities of your real world for your conceptual schema. So whatever conceptual schema we are having, that is your ER diagram. So due to this advantage of your ER diagram, that you are getting the complete system in one loop, right? Many database design tools draw an concept from the ER diagram. They use ER diagram to show the concept of their enterprise. Okay, so main part of your ER diagram are: one is entity, second is relationship, third is attribute of the entity. So we'll go one by one for the definition of that. Here you can see I have added the definition for entity. If you want, you note down or remember the definition. Entity is an object that exists and is distinguishable from other objects. So in your ER diagram, suppose I am having student as one of the entity set. So that will not be repeated again in my ER diagram. So it is unique. Always the entity names are unique in your ER, in one ER diagram I'm talking. So an entity is an object, or you can also say entity is a real world thing. Object is a real world thing, right? So entity is an object, or you can say real world thing, that exists and is distinguishable from other object. Okay, from other entities you can say. For example, specific person, if you want to say, company, event, plant, all these are nothing. Specific person I am saying means, suppose I am having student as one of the, I'm representing in my ER diagram student as a set. Suppose I'll just do one thing. Word. Okay, suppose insert shapes. I'll just show you for roughly for your understanding. Suppose I am having one entity. I am taking this entity as a. Okay, I am saying this is student, right? So this student for your class is my entity set. Suppose this is my I will say college management system. So student is one of the entity set I require. So here, for suppose I am going for your my whole college, how many students? Suppose 600 to 800 students are there, right? So here this whole thing, whatever I have written student, it consists of those 800 student over here. So in this student, I will have all the name of the student, ABC, PQR, and those 800. So whatever I required, this 800, this ABC itself is my one entity. This PQR is my second entity. And they are combined together in this student. So this student is known as a entity set. So in this entity set, I am having separate and all entities together. Remember now, so based on this diagram, or sorry, this explanation is an of that particular entity set together. Okay, specific person, concentrate on this. If person is an entity set, then inside there are many persons involved. So those everyone individually is known as an entity, and combining together is known as this entity set. Okay, so definition is given. An entity set is a set of entities of the same type that share the same properties. because student, every student from my college will have the ID, will have the address, will have the city, will have the phone number, email address, and so on. So they are sharing the same properties. Value may differ. Value may differ, remember. So they are combined together into one set that is known as a student. Clear? So here, usually the idea is we never say entity set while drawing the ER diagram. We always say entity only. But actually you should know this difference. So for that purpose, I'm showing you this difference. What is entity and what is entity set? Okay, so now these all entities or entity set which we are having, they are having the attributes. Suppose I am taking the student. So every student will have their name. Every student will have the address, right? So the every entity will have some or other attributes. Okay, so now any doubt into this, anyone, or it is clear what is an entity? Okay, if it is clear, just put your answer in chat box so that I'll come to know. Okay, so we'll move ahead. Second part. Attributes. As I told you, every entity will have their attributes, right? So attribute is nothing but the thing which will represent your entity. Due to attributes, you will understand who is that student, right? Because if I will say, I'm having the attribute as a student, name is an attribute for the student. So this name, this address, this phone number will describe my entity student, okay? This name, address, or we can say a phone number, I cannot put this for some other entity. Maybe the same thing available, same attributes applicable to other entities also, but the value will differ. Okay, so the definition for the attribute is an entity is represented by a set of attributes that is descriptive properties processed by all members of an entity set. See, here I have specified entity. Why? Because each and every entity of my entity set will have that, will use that, those attributes, or every entity will have that attribute. Every student will have name, every student will have address. So an entity is represented by a set of attributes. Those are descriptive properties of that entity, possessed by all members of that entity set. Because every member of that entity set will have that attribute. Every student from my student entity set will have the name. Okay, fine. So next we'll go. See here, now customer is my entity set. Customer is the entity set here, you can see. This customer entity set will have the attributes like customer ID, customer name, customer street, customer city. So these are the attributes I have added over here. I think I'll just extend this. Okay, so here you can see this is my customer. Is an entity set which is having, forget about the second part, which is having the attributes such as customer ID. Now here, usually, see somewhere, you can see here, I have used underscore. When I will go for the slideshow, that will be more clear for you. Here, when I'm going for this underscore, everywhere you can see, when I'm having the two name together for one attribute, I'm joining them using the underscore. So remember, in database, spaces are not allowed. We are using underscore in between, which means this is my one attribute or whatever combined together. If you want to represent, you have to use underscore. Dash is not allowed. Okay, so you have to show with the help of underscore. Okay, Sometimes dash is accepted based on the type of which software you are using, but underscore is accepted everywhere in database system. So remember, joining two words, always use the underscore part. Fine, clear with this? So these, another doubt you may get here, that is why I'm using customer underscore ID. Why not only ID or name or street, city? The reason behind this is like, I'm having customer as one of the entity in my ER diagram or entity set right now. I will also have employee as another entity for my banking system, because in bank employees are important, like customer. So employee will also have the attribute as name. So if I will just use name for my customer, again for employee I will use name for, as an attribute name, then it is like same attribute together. I can see in my ER diagram. Fine, in ER diagram it is okay, because you know at that time it is a employee and then having the attribute name. This is a customer entity set for which you are having the name. But when you will go for logical implementation, when you will share this together, show the relationship between employee and the customer, that time I will have name together, but I don't know which name is this. This is employee name or customer name, because there I am writing in query form. So to avoid that, I have used here customer underscore ID. You can give any name for attribute. For example, here I can also write C underscore ID accepted. I will write CID without underscore, without space. That is also accepted. I'll write cust underscore ID accepted. So all these naming structure for my customer are accepted. So you can either go for just cust underscore ID, you can go for CID, you can go for C underscore ID. All these are accepted. Only thing, you cannot write C space ID. Then it is like two different things. Space is not accepted. Okay, so that way, that is the main point which I want to show you about the attributes. Same way, another entity I have taken here as a loan entity set, which is having two attributes, loan number and amount. Okay, so a attribute name can be anything, but see to it that you some other person is able to read your attribute name. Suppose I am just writing AMT for amount. Yes, most of the people know that we are writing, it is related with loan and amount, we can write by AMT. Fine, accepted. But don't write some other name which is not common or which other person will not understand. Okay, that is about the attributes. Next part is a domain. Domain is nothing but related with the values. The set of permitted values for each attribute. Now, I am having customer ID. But somewhere I will have the customer ID from starting this role, this number and ending this number. So that whole set is nothing but the domain for attribute customer ID. Suppose I am having student. Suppose I am having here a student as my.
Hello.
Why this is center aligned? Student as my entity. With attributes, I am saying student underscore ID, then S name, student name, where it is gone. Then I am having S name, S address. Time being, I will consider only this. Okay, so student is my entity set, which is having student ID. So for student ID, suppose I am going to consider for your class my roll number. Student ID, instead of that, I think student ID, we should go for student or directly we can go for
Hello.
Roll number, because no one else will have the roll number in this case study. So roll number of my student for SCIT should start from, I'll say 1 to 64. So this 1 to 64, whatever values I am having, 1, then 2, 3, and so on, up to 64, is nothing but domain for attribute roll number. Okay, so similarly for S name, I will create a domain, or I will have a domain that S name has to be from so and so. Because if I am getting that list already from the office, that student name is so and so. So I have written here customer name. Student name can be from these three only. So as I am having your attendance, I can copy your name. Somewhere I will keep those names together for my query. That name of the student should be from this domain only. That is known as a domain. Yes, okay. Sir. So set of all values for customer attribute is known as a domain for that customer name. Clear? Domain is clear. Attributes are clear. Everyone, can we move ahead? So we have studied what is ER diagram, what are the components of ER diagram, what is entity set, what is entity in that entity set, then attributes and domain. Okay, we'll move ahead. Then we have these other symbols, which last time I told you when we roughly saw the ER diagram. Entity is represented with this notation, that is a rectangle notation. Always remember, during exam, don't go for, many students are doing common mistake, that is in place of this rectangle, they are drawing this ellipse or oval shape, which is totally wrong. And your ER diagram carry 10 marks. If you are basic difference, you are basically you are doing this mistake, that is the first mistake of the notation. Who will check your diagram further? Nobody is interested for that, because you don't know the symbol only. So, my dear student, don't do this mistake, common mistake. Because every year I have seen, at least there is one or other student who is doing this mistake. In place of entity, they are showing this notation, which is attribute notation actually, right? So this is entity notation, rectangle, relationship notation. This is diamond structure. Remember, sometimes students are not showing this diamond notation between entity. Always a communication will take place through the relationship only in ER diagram. You cannot show direct line from one entity to another without relationship box in between, or without any relationship in between. That is also wrong, and this is again a common mistake from 4 to 5 students till now. Whatever, whenever I have checked the paper, I have seen this is a mistake from the student. This showing this notation is done by, I can say, 2% or 1%, but just connecting one entity to another just with a line without relationship is like a 5 to 6%, where it is covered in lecture. Just you need to pay attention. Okay, fine. So symbols are clear. Now next is relationship set. Just we have seen there is a relationship set between the entities. Okay, but what type of relationship sets you can have? So 1 minute. An attribute can also be a property of the relationship set. Till now we have seen what is an attribute. Sorry, here an attribute is a property of my entity set, entity in entity set, right? But your attribute can also be a property of relationship set. Suppose this customer is my one entity set. They have just, we have just elaborated it with the entities inside it. Okay, this is account as another entity set with all these entities. Account numbers I have shown over there, right? So here, customer with customer name, account with account number. I think I need to go with the slideshow. Yeah, now it is clear, right? So here I am having customer with customer name, account with account number. How they are related with each other? With the help of depositor, right? Right now, don't think about this oval notation. This is just for your understanding. What is relationship set? Okay, ER diagram notation is not this. Fine. So now here, I know that Johnson is connected with account number A101 through this diagram and via the relationship depositor, right? But how do I know what exactly they have done? also only having the detail like Johnson with account number, I will not get the complete detail. So if I required, I can add access date as one of the attribute for my relationship depositor. So with the help of this, I will get a clear idea that Johnson accessed the account A101 on so and so date, access date, or deposited amount in account was A101 on 24th May 2005. Okay, so this way you can add more attributes to the relationship set if you want. This is just for your understanding. One example is given. So sometimes in exam they give you ER diagram also, and they asked you identify all the entities, identify all the relationship sets, identify the attributes for entity set and further in detail what type of attribute, and that we will see go on. But till now, till here clear, attributes can also be a property of relationship set. Okay, that is only given the depositor relationship set between entity sets, customer and account may have the attribute access date. Okay, which I showed you just now. Now this degree of relationship set, how the entities are communicating together, that is known as a degree of relationship set. Okay, so it is also known as a cardinality. Okay, cardinality or multiplicity. Okay, that we will see later on next slide. So refer to number of entity sets that participate in a relationship set. Suppose I am having, I'll just show you. Suppose I am having this one student. I'm having another student. Right now I'm considering only one name. Just don't get confused with that. So I need diamond also, right? Sorry. So here, and then I need to show the connection. So this is rough idea, roughly I have drawn, because right now we don't have board, and this chapter is more interested to teach with the board, right? So here you can see I have one entity student, and here I will say teacher or faculty, and here we will add it as teachers, right? So we have this relationship. So in this relationship right now, how many entities are together, how many entities are participating in this? Entity sets are participating in this relationship teaches. Give me answer with this. I got some answer over here. Yeah, two. So right, one is student and second is teacher, right? These two entity sets are participating in the relationship teaches. So what this is known as a binary relationship. This teacher's relationship is known as a binary because two entities are participating. If there is one more entity coming in picture, suppose we are having this as a class, we will say teacher teaches in so and so class, right? So here we are having this class, and that is again connected together. Assume the line. Okay, I will just show instead of assumption, simple line. I know these are simple things, but without all these you will like just map is running fast and we are not getting it. So here now how many entities are participating in the relationship teacher teaches? One is student, three, right? second is teacher, and third is class. So this degree of this relationship teachers is now ternary. Okay, so when number of entities which are participating in the relationship set is known as a degree of that relationship set. So here you can see, here we are having refers to number of entity sets that participate in a relationship set. This is the definition for that which just now I showed you. So when two entities are involved into the relationship set, it is known as a binary or degree 2. Okay, second, when there three entities are entity sets are participating, it is known as a ternary. And more than three entity sets when participating, it is known as a n-ary. So it is represented like this. Just we are writing for that n-ary. Like two tier, three tier, then n tier. The same way we are having binary, ternary, or n-ary. Okay. So usually in ER diagram, binary is accepted. Ternary is at the worst case. If you required, without that your diagram cannot be complete, is accepted. But then people may ask you, suppose you required to break this ternary relationship and you want to make it in the form of binary, what you can do? So for that we will learn extended ER diagram later on. Okay, right now remember, relationship sets may involve more than two entity sets. Relationship between more than two entity sets are rare. That is the thing I told you. Only in worst case, if it is not possible, then only you will show for a ternary or n-ary. But usually it is always preferable to go with binary relationship, that is degree. Okay, so that is for a binary relationship set, degree of relationship set. Now here you can see relationship sets with their attributes. I think slightly I have to go. So here I am having customer, depositor. This is the proper notation. These are all our proper notation for ER diagram. Customer, depositor, and account. Account and customer are my entity set, are related with the relationship set depositor. Customer is having the attribute as customer ID, customer name, customer street, customer city. Account is having attributes as account number and balance. So remember, your entities are always connected with a relationship. Never show the diagram like this. Entity connected to another entity, and on top of this write down features. This is wrong. The way you have entity and entity never communicate without the relationship set. So that you require this in between always. So this mistake you should not do when you are working on a ER diagram. As I said, your relationship can also have an attribute. So we have added that with the access date. All these attributes are connected with a solid line to your entity sets. Okay, or relationship set. Now here access date is an attribute, not an entity set. Remember, otherwise you will say this is ternary now. Wrong. This is binary. Only two are participating in this relationship set. Okay. Now there is one more notation in this diagram present. Can anyone tell me? I told you about the entities. I told you about the relationship set. I told you about the attributes. There is one more notation you can see over there in the diagram. Can anyone tell me what, which notation is there? But I have not talked about that right now. Underline in attribute, correct? So here you can see some notation is given. For customer, I have added customer ID with underline. For account, I have added account number as a underline. Yes, correct. The answer is correct. That is known as a primary key. About keys, we will learn in detail different types of keys, but right now with without that this part, it is ER diagram is incomplete. So I need to tell you, this is known as a primary key for this entity set. Okay, what is a primary key? Primary key is always unique for that particular entity. For example, customer. Every customer in a bank will have a customer ID, and that is a unique ID for that particular customer. So that is known as a primary key for that customer. Your account, your whatever your account is having, you are getting account number from the bank, and that account number is unique. It is not same for other person. Otherwise, everything will be like mess in a bank. One person will get deposited by default by other person, and so on. So primary key is one of the important thing in your ER diagram for your entity set. Without primary key, your ER diagram is incomplete. So definition and in detail we will go for later on. So right now, remember, this is a primary key. And every entity need entity set, we can say, or entity inside it need to have a primary key. The primary key present for the entity set, that entity set is known as a strong entity set. Remember the word strong entity set, that it has its own existence due to this primary key. Okay, so strong entity set definition, they ask you for 2 marks, means they ask 5 definition for 2 marks. They ask for this strong entity set, or usually they ask types of entity set. So here you can write for this. One is strong entity set, second type I will tell you after some time. So strong entity set is the entity set which has its own identity through with the help of primary key. So that is known as a strong entity set. In this case, our customer and account, these both are strong entity set as they have primary key present in the attribute. Fine. So we'll go ahead. Okay. Why relationship have attribute? Yes. It is not compulsory that every relationship should have an attribute. Sometimes we require that if I will not add this access date over here. So with the customer, I'll come to know that this is a customer ID. Customer deposited into my bank account number. From this, I will get the account number. Right now, this is the balance. But nowhere I have the attribute, that is the access, when they have deposited the amount in my banking system, right? So that data I require, that is a deposited, na? So depositor relation, it is related with the deposit amount. So that attribute I am adding to this relationship. To get more clear idea, more detail, I require to add the attribute for my relationship set. Again, I am saying it is not compulsory, but if you will add this, then your ER diagram will get more value over there, that it is not missing any information. Okay, because right now, if you are missing anything over here, the same thing you are going to implement in a query format, that is a logical structure. So again, you will face problem over there. So I have added here access date as my deposit account. With this, I will come to know when I have deposited in my account. Okay, or when customer has deposited in their account. Clear, Pratna?
Yes, so, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, so we'll move ahead. We are having review. We saw the relationship sets with attribute. Now, as you can see here, I have all just oval. All attributes are just ellipse or oval. No other notation I have added over here, right? But there are different types of attribute, and this was the 5 marks question. Define attributes with its all types and example. So this is one of the important thing. I think we should go with this. This diagram, this part is very interesting. Attribute types. There are first is a simple and composite attribute. Simple and composite attribute means what? Normal attribute, simple attribute, which are not having any further division. So suppose I am having here a customer name. Yes, my customer will have their name, right? Okay. So it is normal attribute name. I will call this attribute name as a attribute, as a simple attribute. Opposite to the simple attribute, I said composite attribute. Composite attribute is the attribute which combines more attribute together, or you can say which can be further divide. So now suppose I am having customer street. Okay, here I have added the customer street and city together. Suppose I will, instead of these two attribute, I will show it. For the student, suppose I am writing address, student address. So definitely this student address is combined together with street, city, then it is further divided into postal code if you required. Okay, and so on. I'm just writing two for understanding. So here, this address is my attribute of my entity student, but this attribute further can be divided into this part for better understanding. So this is known as the address is known as the composite attribute. Means the attribute which can be further classified into more attribute, or which can be divided into other attribute, is known as a composite attribute. Now with the help of this, as I gave you one example, address, can you give me any example which can act as a composite attribute? One is the address as I gave you. Now you people try for other example. The attribute which can
name,
correct. So name can be further divided into first name, middle name, last name. Yes, correct. So that way I can have my name divided into further part. So that is known as, sorry, I will show you this slide. Yeah, so here this customer name can also act as a composite attribute because I can further divide it into different parts, right? Any other example? One we got address, second we got name. Okay, likewise you will get many example when you will go ahead with your ER diagram. Fine. So this part is clear, simple and composite attribute. Simple means which cannot be further divided into more attributes. Okay, now I will show the diagram for all these composite attribute and all, but right now just for understanding. Single valued and multi-valued. Single valued, that the attribute which will have only one value for the particular entity set, that is known as a single valued and multi-valued. Suppose I am having a student. So student, I am saying customer ID. Customer ID can be only one for one student. Okay, so that is single value. Suppose for student, I am having one more attribute known as a phone number. So one student may have two phone numbers, correct? One customer may have two phone number, more than two phone number, or more than one phone number, I can say, correct? So if any attribute, phone number is my attribute for the customer, which can have more than one value, is known as a multi-valued attribute. Now I gave you example as a phone number. Can you give me example for this multi-valued
attribute? Aadhar card.
Aadhar card. Aadhar card.
Aadhar card number is multi-valued.
How? Krishna, Aadhar card number for one person is only one. We cannot have two Aadhar card numbers for one person. Correct?
Yeah, we can have pin code.
Pin code can also be only one. Because right now, the place where I stay, the pin code is one only. So with my address, only one pin code will come. If I'm changing my address, then that pin code will come. This pin code is not valid. Correct? So phone number one, which I told you.
Mobile
number or phone number, same thing. It will go on. Nickname you can be more, okay. Email ID, yeah, email ID can be more than one. Customer location you have written, but location can further classify, right? So that is a composite attribute. So the same way, email address can be more than one for one person. Phone numbers can be more than one person. And further, you will get more thing about this when you will go for ERDIM. So that is multi-valued address, correct. Next is derived attribute. Derived attribute is the attribute which is derived from another attribute, from your from present attribute. Suppose I'll explain this. Suppose we are having, okay, what is the difference between composite and multi-valued? Yeah, I'll tell you. Temporary and permanent address. Yes, address can be temporary and permanent address, but then here you are getting the division of that as a temporary and permanent. If your can your permanent address be two? No. Can your temporary address, temporary address two? No. Your address is further divided into temporary and permanent. So address can act as a composite address. Okay. Dinesh, clear? Your temporary address and permanent address, correct. Those are the two types of address. But those two values, if you want to show, you can say that as a multi-valued. But again, I am getting the clarity over there. These are two different addresses. Not the one person, one address. You can show that as a multi-valued, but not exactly. Okay. Account numbers can be multi-valued because one person may have more than one account number. Okay. Similarly, here, what is the difference between composite and multi-valued? Composite, I'll show you one diagram for that. Derived attribute will come later on. See a student. When I'm saying name of the student, or customer or anyone, name can be divided into first name, middle name and last name. When I will combine this together, first name, middle name and last name, I will get my name. So this name attribute I can divide into in detail description. So that is known as a composite attribute. So name is my composite attribute. Similarly, address can be divided into street, city, state. So when I will combine all this together, I will get my address as one person. Now I don't remember the name, Mitesh or Dinesh, I think. He said address can be permanent or temporary. Those are types of the attribute. That is not the division of the attribute. That part we will come later on when we will go for generalization or extended ER diagram. Okay, so when I will combine these together, I will get my address. Similarly, street I can divide as a street number, street name, apartment number. When I will combine these together, I will get street. Okay, so here my address is a composite attribute. Again, here street is a composite attribute. Clear? Composite attribute. Now, multi-valued means what? Suppose name. I want to say student name. From your class only we will take. So first name. So roll number one. Suppose I am putting the data. What is the first name for the student? Suppose we are saying, I think Alfred in your class. So first name will be the Alfred. Whatever is the middle name. So I will say A is the first name. B is the middle name. And C is the last name, right? So here, one student will have only one name, that is A. Second student may have other name, P. But this one student will have only one first name. We are not talking about a nickname over here because this is my proper name for the student in my register. Okay, so one student is having only one name, that is my proper name, right? So here, that is known as a normal simple attribute. Middle name is again one only, no two name as a middle name. Last name will be again one only, not two. So these all together are making my complete name. So this name attribute is a composite attribute. So how many values first name is having, Mitesh? First name for every student, how many values you will have? Yes, Mitesh, this was I think your doubt. So that's why I'm asking you. Yeah, Mitesh, you are there? So in this case, yeah, first name, how many first name, you first name for one student you will have?
One only.
One only. So that is the way, this is one value. So one, all these together will make name. The composite attribute is clear for you. So yes. Now I will tell you all multi value. We'll come to this part later on. So this is the diagram for your, I go with your slide. So here I have added somewhere, yeah, phone number. Here you can see phone number. So now this customer will have more than one phone number values. Remember the values I am talking. Phone number values. How many phone numbers of customer can have? But there are customers who are having only one phone number. But we can have a thousand customer who will have more than one phone number. So it is known as a multi-value. The value will be double or more than one is known as a multi-value. Now clear?
Yes,
difference between composite and multi-value. Don't get confused, okay? Fine. So that was the correct doubt. So we were at third time. Derived attribute, right? So derived attribute, as I told you, the attribute which is derived from another attribute. Suppose you know the, you have added as a date of birth for the student. Okay? You know the date of birth. Suppose we are having the student as an entity. For student, I have added the attribute as a date of birth. So this is my attribute for the student. Now I know current today's date, whatever is it, that every person knows the date, current date, that is we usually call it as a system date. So with the help of date of birth and current date or system date, I can find out the age of that student. Correct? Students, give your answers in our chat box so that I will come to know, I can move ahead. So with the help of date of birth and current system date, I can find out the age of the student. So that is my age with the help of system date, right? So here date of birth can be the attribute for my student. So again, do I need to add the attribute as an age? No need. Actually, there is no requirement to add the attribute as an age for the student, because I can find out the age value of particular student using the date of birth attribute. But still I want to show this attribute in my ER diagram, then that will be my derived attribute, because it is derived from the date of birth. So here you can see I have shown example as a age given by date of birth. Okay, so now this is one example. Age is a derived attribute from the date of birth. Can you give me any other attribute? Okay, I will give you entity for that. Suppose I am having employee. For employee, can you give me? Or
salary.
You can, salary, how you will calculate salary? With which attribute? No. Average salary is okay, but never we show average salary as an attribute. That we can calculate later on. No. Employee full name cannot be derived. Employee full name is a composite attribute. Yes. I got the
employee's age can be derived.
Yes, that is the age. We have already written age, whether it is employee or student, same way with the help of date of birth. This answer is correct. I got somewhere years to work. Suppose I am having employee joining date and current system date. So with the help of that, I can calculate the total employment for that employee. That is years work, as Steve wrote. So that is correct. That attribute can be a derived attribute. Annual income. Annual income, how you will calculate? Annual income. Ohm. Annual income of the employee, how you will calculate? No, we cannot calculate. We require that total monthly income, and that every month income we require. With one value, we cannot derive it. So that cannot be. Yes, experience. Years work and experience is same thing. That is total experience. Right now, suppose I want to say how many years I have worked in Xavier. So I will find out my joining date with the help of current date. I will get that total experience. That is the 12 years I can say for in exercise. So that is nothing but how you are getting the other attribute with the help of this. Gross salary cannot be this derived attribute. That is nothing but just calculation. But with one value, you cannot derive these attributes. Skills cannot be that. Skills are other attributes. One example I will give you. Suppose you are in your family, you have four people. Okay, in your family, you have four people. So your parent, your father is only earning for your family. Mother is housewife, and you children, two children, you are studying. Okay, so here, for your father, I can add one attribute, that is dependent, total dependent. How I will get total dependent, that is, this is your multi-valued attribute. Only thing I can calculate as an experience for the job. Salary payment date cannot be derived attribute. Manager of a team. How come this is derived attribute? No. No.
Ma'am, the employees can have the same manager, right? So.
Yes.
So are they derived from the same employee? Same manager?
No. Because you are not having the other value right now here. See, I am not manager of the team is correct. So that is like I will use the foreign key attribute for that. Not I cannot derive it. I will just have this. I need two things to calculate the values. Okay. So right now manager name is already present with that particular employees. Fine. So these are the attribute types. In exam, you may get question for these. You have to write the definition for each one of these. You have to give the example for each one of these. And then you have to show diagrammatic notation for each one of these. So diagrammatic notation till now I have not explained with you. So we'll go for that. This is for composite attribute represented like this. Again, I will show with proper ER diagram. So this is the ER diagram. Where you are having, you can see rectangle, then total summary of that rectangle represent entity set, diamond represent a relationship set. Instead of deposit, now I have taken borrower. Again, here I can add the access date. That is optional part. Okay, links between all these are nothing but connecting entity to the relationship set as well as entities with the attributes. Ellipses are nothing but the attributes of the entity set. Okay, and underline indicate the primary key for attribute that we will study in detail later on. Okay, these all notations plus all the same composite attribute notation, derived attribute notation, and multi-valued attribute notation. So here I have taken only one entity for your understanding. This diagram you have to draw for your attribute answer. Okay. So customer is there. Customer is having customer ID, which is my primary key. So it is unique. It cannot be further divide. It cannot have more than one value. It cannot derive some other attribute. So this is known as my simple attribute. This is also known as my primary key. Okay, composite. I'm having customer name. Customer name can be further classified as first name, middle name, and last name. So this name is known as my which attribute? Name is known as which attribute in this case? It is further divided into other attribute. So it is known as which type of attribute?
Composite.
Similarly, customer is having its address. Address divided into city, street, state, zip code. or postal code, you can say. So this address is again which type of attribute? Student, address is again
composite
attribute.
Multi-valued attribute.
No multi-valued. It is composite, which can be further divided. It will composite. Have only. Yeah, composite. Someone said multi-valued. I don't know who said. Now next is this address is divided into street, city, state, and so on. Again, street can be divided further. So street can also act as a composite attribute. So in exam, when you will draw this diagram with your pencil, you can write down, put arrow, simple attribute / primary key attribute, put arrow for name, address, street, compose, write somewhere composite attribute. Then now here, customer will have phone number. Phone number can, values can be more than one. One customer can have more than one phone number. So this is multi-valued attribute represented with double ellipse. Okay, notation for multi-valued attribute is a double ellipse. Okay, now here, customer is having date of birth, but with the help of date of birth, I can find out the age. So age is my derived attribute represented with dotted ellipse. So derived attributes are represented with dotted ellipse. Clear here? So this attribute, there is no meaning of adding actually this attribute. But sometimes people add or they think this is important, but that will come as a derived attribute. Fine? So these are all diagrammatic representation. Simple attribute is represented with single ellipse. A composite attribute is represented with single ellipse and further attributes divided into multi-valued attribute is represented with double ellipse. Derived attribute is represented with a dotted ellipse. Okay, so all these notations are clear for attributes. Now next is a mapping cardinality. We still have 20 minutes, so I'll complete this mapping cardinality part and then we will stop. So mapping cardinality, it is also known as a cardinality only, or it is known as a multiplicity. Remember these two words, cardinality or multiplicity. In exam, they may ask you, define what is cardinality or what is multiplicity. So you should know that we will see. It is nothing but the number of occurrences of one entity for a single occurrence of the related entity. Number of occurrences of one entity for a single occurrence of the related entity. In simple words, I will tell you the definition. This you have to learn, or if you have to by heart this. But to remember, I will tell you, number of entities participating in the connected relationship is known as a cardinality. Number of entities from that entity set participating in the given relationship set is known as a cardinality or multiplicity. I will explain with the diagram, don't worry. Example, single student can take admission to only one course. So here they have specified single student. So here one will be the cardinality. Can take admission to only one course. Again, here it is a cardinality one. How to represent? Forget about that. Just get the concept first. One customer may have more than one account in a bank. So here, one customer. For customer side, I will have one cardinality. And account side, I will have many. More than one means many. So that is many. Cardinality is many. I will tell you with the representation. For a binary relationship, that is when two entities are taking connected to one relationship set, that is two entities participating to entity set, entity sets participating in one relationship set, that is a binary relationship set, the mapping cardinality must be one of these four, whether it can be one to one, one to many, many to one, or many to many. Remember this. This concept you have to show in your diagram, ER diagram. that is a cardinality or multiplicity. External may ask you question. Now I don't know whether we will have a practical exam or one that is a physically when we will join the college, or whether the situation will be like this, so we will have definitely something like online, but we will have external exam. So we may ask, external may ask you question, that is, what is cardinality or what is multiplicity? Sometimes they use the term multiplicity, so you should know that those terms, right? So it is nothing but how many entities from the entity set participating into a connected relationship set is known as a cardinality. Okay, or you can learn this definition also. So we'll see this. You already know what is one to one. So one wheel connected to one only, that is known as a one to one. One is connected to more than one, that is known as a one to many. This is simple. Right now I am showing just for understanding what is all this one to one, one to many. Okay, then we are having many to one. Many are connected to one. First side many and second is one. And many to many, many are connected to many. These are A1 is connected to B1, A1 is connected to B2. Again, A1 is connected to B1 and A2 is also connected to B1. So many to one, and from here, one to many. So many to many, both side. Fine. So this is for understanding the concept. Exam also you will draw such way only when you are showing the mapping cardinality. So cardinality constraints. Some constraints are there to show the cardinality. One, in ER diagram, how you will show the cardinality. We express cardinality constraint by drawing either a directed line. We are using this to represent the cardinality. When the entity set where you will point this arrow means one cardinality, one. An entity set where you will point this normal solid line, that is many. Remember this way, this is many, and when arrow is there, it is one. So that will be more clear when we'll go for diagram. Now suppose I want to go with one to one relationship set. So one to one relationship, suppose I want to show, I will say a customer is associated with at most one loan via the relationship borrower. What I am saying, a customer, one customer is associated with at most one loan via the relationship set. Okay, a loan is associated with at most one customer via the borrower. See here, remember, identify the borrower. When I am having a borrower as a relationship, what is a borrower meaning? I am borrowing something. So if I am having customer one side, I am having loan at other side. So in this case, borrower means what? One customer has taken at most one loan. That's why that customer name is there in that list. And if loan is there with account number so and so, means that account number with by default will have at most one customer. Correct? So here, otherwise that relationship will not exist. Diagram, I can write like this. When I am having this, forget about one to many. When I am saying customer and borrower with this about two statement, I will represent my diagram like arrow towards this as well as arrow towards loan side. That is one to one. One customer will have at most one loan. Okay, that is one to one. So here also I will have arrow. Arrow indicate one, represent one. And here solid line represent many. So this is one to many. One customer may have more loan. This line represent, or this, how I can represent, read this. A customer can have more than one associated loan. So here more than one means many. Okay, so here we have written, in the one to many relationship set, a loan is associated with at most one customer. If loan is created for one of the account number or one of the customer, will definitely that customer will have at least one loan in that particular bank. So that is, it has to have one, at least one. So at most one customer via the borrower relationship. A customer is associated with several loans via the borrower. When you are saying many, many means what? Zero is also accepted over there. Okay, several. Zero to, we are saying N or M. Zero to N or M means many. Now one notation is clear. Arrow indicate one and solid line indicate many. So this how you will read out, a customer may have more loans in a bank. Okay, more than one loan associated in their account number. Okay, so this is one to many. Right now the concept is to understand the notation over here and what is one to many relationship set. Now this one means one customer is participating and many means having the more than one loan. So more than two account we can say, or loan type for example, loan numbers which they are having. That is more than two entities are participating here and here only one customer is participating. So how many entity set are participating here? One. So it is one, cardinality is one. Here more than two loan numbers, they are related with this one customer number. So it is more than one entity is participating into this borrower relationship set. So it is known as a many. Don't get confused. Slightly, I know this is like you need concentration for this. So here borrower relationship is like one customer may have more than one loan. So here it is known as a one to many cardinality, one to many. Clear? So we'll stop here. I'll not go in detail for many to one and further part because I need to revise also. So further parts we'll cover later on in next lecture. We'll go with the revision. So students, quickly give the answers for questions which I will ask you. We have done with what is modeling, what are the benefits of modeling, then we have seen the types of modeling phases and that. So we'll go with the ER diagram. Who will give me the definition of entity? Give the definition for entity. Okay, one minute. We have something over here. What is this? Time spent on a project. Yes. Yeah, time spent on a project can be a, this is I think related with derived attribute, right, Nihal? Yes. So time spent on a project, that can be a derived attribute. But usually we never write this complete sentence, or to just write times total time duration for a project. So start of the project can be the one of the attribute of your project. And then with the current date, you can find out total time spent for that project. Or if you are having the end of the project, both the attributes you can use for finding the total time spent for that. So time spent can be a, or total duration can be a derived attribute. Correct. Fine. Total number of purchases made by a customer till now, derived attribute. Total number of purchases. For this, which will be your basic attribute? Till now means system debt, that is the current purchase you will consider. And previous purchases. Okay, you can consider previous purchases. But the thing is, for previous purchases, you require to consider many purchases, all the purchases like month one, month two, month three, January, February, March, all those data you require. If you have all those data, that is then definitely you are having everything, then why to go for the total purchases, right? So entity definition, many students wrote that an entity is an object that exists and is distinguishable from other objects. Correct. So definition we got for entity. Oh, it was visible. No. Okay. What is the difference between entity and entity set? Yes, we got answer for entity. What is difference between entity and entity set? You can unmute yourself instead of writing if you want. Because that way we will go quickly with all the points which we have covered.
Entity set is a group of entities having the same properties and same type.
Yes, come again, Steve.
Entity set consists of a group of entities having the same type and
correct. Property. Correct. Entity set is having a group of entities with the which consider or which satisfy the same attributes or having the same characteristic or attribute. Correct. And what is entity?
Entity is a single existing object that can be distinguishable from the other existing objects.
That only you got definition previously also, the correct. Now, what are the attributes? Definition of attribute? Any other person? Yes. Mohammed? I can't hear you. I'm not able to listen you. Attributes. Attributes are for which part we will add in ER diagram? Whether you are talking or not, I don't know, we can't hear you. Some other person? No, Mohammed, we can't. Yes.
It describes the property of the entity.
Yes. Can we also add the attributes for a relationship set? Can we add attributes for the relationship set?
Yes.
Yes, descriptive property. No or yes?
Yes.
Yes, we can add the attributes for the relationship set also. Correct. So then we have seen the example of that. What is a domain?
That contains value of attribute.
It contains?
Value of attribute.
Values of set of attributes, permitted set of attribute for that particular attribute. Yeah, correct. Then we have seen after that the symbols for all the things. Okay, so I will ask quickly the symbols for everything. Entity is represented as a
rectangle.
Attribute is represented as a
oval shape.
Oval or ellipse. Then relationship set is represented as a
diamond.
Then multi-valued attribute is represented as a
double oval.
Yes. Mm-hmm. A derived attribute is represented as a
dotted ellipse.
Yes. And composite attribute is represented as a
ellipse
which is further divided into other ellipse.
Yeah.
So yes, that is our composite attribute. So that we have done. What is relationship set? We have seen an attribute of that. What is degree of relationship set? Degree.
The number of entities are there in relationship.
Yes. The number of entities set. Entity set who are participating in that particular relationship set is known as that. So we have seen binary, ternary and nary relationship set, right? Then we have seen the attribute for relationship set done. Types of attribute, just now we spoke with the notation, so I'll not go in detail of that right now. Notation of all that we have seen and this is done. Then what is the definition for cardinality or multiplicity?
Number of occurrence of the one entity for a single occurrence of the related entity.
Yes, so that is known as a cardinality or multiplicity. In simple words, we have seen how many entities from the entity set are participating in a connected attached relationship set. Okay, that is known as a cardinality or multiplicity. Out of that, we have seen one to one. One customer can have only one loan. So that is one to one. One to many. One customer can have many loan. So that is one to many. This is in simple word I showed you. The Cork book, they have given such way for your understanding. But in simple way, that is the way. One to one, one to many. Next is when we are want to represent it as a one cardinality, we can use a arrow point, and for many cardinality we will use a solid line notation. Okay, so these notations will be more clear when we will go with a proper ER diagram. Fine. Then we have not covered with the many to one and many to many. That we will again start with all these four mapping cardinality in next lecture. Okay. So till here, any doubt if you have, please ask. Meanwhile, I need to take attendance also. So first we'll go for any doubt if any student is having. Please let me know.
No, ma'am.
No. So we'll just quickly go for our attendance. We have done till 7 roll number. 8 also done. 9, roll number 9 is there.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
Then we have 19 is not there. 20.
Present.
21.
Present.
21, you were absent for last lecture.
Yes.
So be attentive now onwards, okay? 22.
Present, ma'am.
22, Aman. Aap kaha the do din le aap lecture miss kiye, right? You were not there for two lectures, previous two lectures. 23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
26.
27.
Present, ma'am.
28. Present, ma'am. 29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am. 34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40. 41.
Present, ma'am.
42.
Present, ma'am.
43. Oh, sorry, 44.
Present, ma'am.
46.
Present, ma'am.
47.
Present, ma'am.
48.
Present, ma'am.
49.
Present, ma'am.
50. 51. 51 is absent today. 52.
Present, ma'am.
53.
Present, ma'am.
54.
Present, ma'am.
55.
Present, ma'am.
56.
Present, ma'am.
57. 57 was there, I think.
Present.
58.
Present.
59.
Present.
मैम 51 प्रेजेंट
51 कौन है हाँ अपने प्रेजेंट नहीं बोला ना
नहीं
ओके ओके देन वी वर एट 59 डन राइट 59 आई सॉ यू 60
प्रेजेंट
61 62 61, 62 is not there. 63.
Present, ma'am.
63. This is your first lecture, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Why?
Ma'am, now onwards I will attend.
Okay. Fine. 64.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, 64. 64 not there. 65.
Present, ma'am.
66. This person is also continuously absent. Kaustubh? Kaustubh is absent today.
Miss, can we leave after our attendance is done?
Yes, yes. Sure, sure. Those who have doubt, they can wait. The remaining student can leave, please. Kaustubh is there?
Present, ma'am. Kaustubh.
Yes. Then Rishikesh?
Present.
Yes, okay. Those who are done with attendance, please leave. Thank you. Yes, we have something. I'll stop presenting first. One relationship joining to another with two solid undirected line. Prasanth, can you come online if you are there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is your doubt actually?
Ma'am, if one relationship is connected to the other with two undirected lines, like solid lines, what does it represent like?
One minute, I didn't get. You mean?